Well, hello everybody and welcome back to Good Morning Sri Lanka once again. If you were tuned in, you'd have noticed that we were talking about diabetes. And one thing we were discussing with the lovely doctors we have in the studio is that diabetes is a recognized problem in Sri Lanka. And about approximately there's like a detection of about 15 to 20% of diabetic patients in Sri Lanka, and that is detected alone. So it is a big problem, and here at Good Morning Sri Lanka we want to educate you about it and tell you so that you get a good idea of what you need to do if you think you are suffering from diabetes. So I'm gonna direct some more questions to our doctors, and this one is for Dr. Sharma. Dr. Sharma, can you tell me what are the risks of developing diabetes?
Yeah, some people have high potential to develop diabetes, whereas some people don't. So we call these factors, if present in particular individual, as risk factors for diabetes. Mm-hmm. So we can broadly divide these risk factors into two categories: modifiable risk factors and non-modifiable risk factors. So non-modifiable risk factors are the age and your race and ethnicity and your genetics. So the people who are above 45 years of age are at high risk of developing diabetes. And being Asians, we are at high risk of developing diabetes. Asians and Hispanics are at high risk of developing diabetes. And also your genetics. That means if you have a family member or members, first degree relatives who are having diabetes, you are at great risk of developing diabetes. Unfortunately, we can't change these factors. So we have to put a great emphasis into the factors that are modifiable. So a person who is spending a sedentary lifestyle, eating unhealthy foods, eating a lot of sugars, are at high risk of developing diabetes. And also a person who is under a lot of stress for a long period of time are at high risk. And if your weight is not well maintained, that means if you are obese or overweight, you are again at high risk of developing diabetes. So these modifiable risk factors are the ones we have to look into. And a mother, if a mother delivered a baby more than 3.5 kilograms of weight, or if mother develop a gestational diabetes mellitus, it is a special type of diabetes occur only during the pregnancy. So if particular mother develops that, she is at high risk of developing diabetes later in her life. So if we identify these modifiable risk factors and adjust our lifestyle, we can prevent or delay the diabetes in a particular individual.
I see. So how does one really find out when they have diabetes? What are the symptoms really like for diabetes, Dr. Appa?
Yeah. The problem is before being diagnosed as diabetes, most of the people, they don't have any symptoms. They don't have no symptoms at all. So you have the disease, but you don't know that you have the disease because you don't feel anything. So at the time of diagnosis, you have lived with the disease for about maybe 5 to 10 years, maybe even more than that. So at the diagnosis, the complications might have occurred. So the most important thing is when you have the risk factors that Dr. Sharma already mentioned, you should check your blood sugar to find out whether you have the diabetes or not.
I see.
So sometimes people present with symptoms like frequent.
I think we've got a slide also, right, doctor, on
yes,
the screen.
That is needing to urinate more frequently, blurred vision, feeling hunger, feeling tired, wounds that won't heal easily, vaginal infections, urine infections, skin infections, and some sexual problems as well.
So all these are symptoms.
Yeah,
of
so one when one is having those symptoms, it's important to check the blood sugar level.
I see. And Dr. Asanta, now something like diabetes, is it preventable?
Yeah, rather than giving you a straight yes or no, straightforward yes or no, as Dr. Sharma already described, you know, there are modifiable as well as non-modifiable risk factors. So, as one can understand, the non-modifiable risk factors, we can't do much about those risk factors, like genetics, the ethnicity or the advanced age. But the modifiable risk factors, such as the sedentary lifestyle, lack of exercise, obesity, unhealthy dietary patterns, those things we can of course intervene and modify.
Rasanthi is telling, the diabetes is a disease which we can prevent, but probably once it occurs in our body, it is not curable. But it can be well under controlled, and we can prevent the complications of diabetes.
So when you say prevent, I mean it's all about having a healthy lifestyle, eating right, taking the right amounts of sugar, exercise, etc. Am I right?
Even if you are at risk because of genetics or advanced age or the non-modifiable, because of the non-modifiable risk factors, still you can make an effort and delay the development of diabetes. So you can have a good life.
So to get one thing straight, diabetes is something that you cannot cure.
Yes.
Correct? But it is something that can be controlled.
Which is controlled in a way, in majority, it's preventable as well.
Preventable, but when you get it, you can't cure it, but you can control it. I see. Now, for somebody who has got it, I mean, you can't cure it, as we just spoke. So, Dr. Sharma, how is that going to change that person's lifestyle?
Yeah, definitely. You need to, the first thing, once you diagnosed as having diabetes, there are certain things that you should do in your life if you are going to have a good lifetime for the rest of your lifespan. So one thing, you need to get educated about your illness. So there are enough leaflets, books and media will tell you about your diabetes. So first thing, the person who diagnosed as having diabetes should be thoroughly educated about the illness. Then only the person get motivated to control the diabetes. So the second thing is, you need to go to your doctor, and doctor will prescribe you medications, plus he will give you a diet, and you have to adhere to that diet, and also the exercise program. Now normally we ask the healthy person to do half an hour exercise every other day. For the diabetic person also it is same.
So you say exercise, you mean like cardio?
Yeah, usually we say moderate intensity exercise plus some aerobic and weight bearing exercise to strengthen the muscles also. So just aerobics will not do. So what we need to do is do about 15 minutes of aerobic exercises, something like running, cycling, and also about 15 minutes of weight bearing exercises. So you can go to gym and you can use the machines, weights to do that. And if you are overweight or obese, we usually recommend 1 hour exercise per day for obese and overweight people, because they need to lose their weight as well.
I see. Well, Dr. Epa, I'm going to toss this question out to you. Now, it's a clear fact that we've identified that sugar is a huge cause for diabetes. But at the same time, if you are having diabetes, intake of sugar is something that needs to be reduced. But when you do have diabetes, what are the kind of foods that people are not supposed to have and supposed to have? And also, if you can't take sugar, what are the alternatives?
Now, why is that important? Because when it comes to the management of diabetes, it is very important to control your diet. We call it medical nutrition therapy. It's a very critical treatment option in the diabetes management. So there are certain factors that affect the control of diabetes. Most of these factors are controlled by the patient, not by the doctor. So it's patient is more responsible regarding the management. When it comes to the diet, there are some models to understand how much and what you should take.
Like, and also, doctor, I think we have a slide as right, well.
That is what we call the plate model.
Oh, okay.
It's very easy to understand. The one half of the plate should contain vegetables, and the other half should divide into two equal halves. one should contain grains and starches, and the other half should contain the proteins.
I see.
And there's another model, what we call it, the Zimbabwe hand jive model. Mm-hmm. In that, the carbohydrate you should take as much as your fist, one fist vegetable, sorry, one fist fruit, and one fist starch. And the protein you should take as much as your palm, the size of your palm, and the thickness of your little finger. And the vegetable you should take as much as you can hold in your hands. Mm-hmm. And the lipid
this is what we can see on screen right now, right?
And the lipid you should take very little amount, a pat, as much as the tip of your thumb. So and there are certain things, as you all know, sweetens, sweet mm-hmm. things you should avoid in diabetes. And you asked about the sweetens.
Yes.
Actually, there are some diabetic chocolates and sweetens you can add into your tea. We don't recommend to use those things because it may not add any sugar to your diet, but it will add more calorie to your diet. So you will get more calorie by taking this. So we don't actually recommend to take those things.
Well, of course, getting this disease also comes with its fair share of problems. So Dr. Asanth, if you can enlighten us on what are the complications when it comes to having diabetes.
You're talking about the complications. As Dr. Sharma mentioned earlier, diabetes is not merely high blood sugar level. It carries a risk of developing complications. Actually, the complications are the major, it comprises the major burden of diabetes when it comes to management.
Yeah, it's a multi-system disease, really, which can affect any organs in the body. Yeah.
We call the complications, we call it actually the long-term complications can be, we call it macrovascular and microvascular complications. As the name implies, macrovascular is the long-term diabetes will affect the large blood vessels of your body. So a person can get things like heart attacks, stroke, and distal lower limb problems. And when it comes to microvascular complications, where you are the small blood vessels of the body will be affected. So the eyesight will be affected, your kidneys will be affected, and your nerves will be affected. So those are the long-term complications. In addition to that, the combination of these factors will lead to a complication called diabetic foot, which is one of the most debilitating thing to happen in diabetes, and one of the commonest presentations to the hospital.
And diabetes is the commonest cause of amputations as well.
So those are the long term complications, and there are a certain group of the patients who come to the emergency department with severe dehydration and high blood sugar levels. So we call it diabetic ketoacidosis and hyposmolar states. So certain proportion of those patients actually are detected as diabetes when they come to the emergency department.
Okay.
So those are the complications that one can get with diabetes.
All right. Well, we've been talking a lot about diabetes, what diabetes is about, and how it affects one's lifestyle. And of course, we're going to go in for a short commercial break. When we do come back, we're going to talk about diabetes and its treatments. Don't go away, we've got a lot more to talk about, to educate you. So don't go away, we'll be right back here on Good Morning Sri Lanka.